Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. Thank you so much for tuning in. In today's video, we're going to be discussing some of our top recommended astrophotography equipment upgrades that you can make to change your setup into something that we refer to as an advanced imaging rig. So in this video, we'll be recommending some pretty awesome equipment upgrades that's going to take your imaging rig to the next level, starting off with an electronic autofocuser. Being able to remotely control and schedule your autofocus routine is a huge advantage over a Batinoff mask, and it produces surprisingly sharper stars than a Batinoff mask would. These sit in our number 5 spot because they are a complete game changer as far as automation is concerned. So next on our list of game-changing equipment upgrades is an off-axis guider, or an OAG, and this becomes absolutely necessary when you start imaging with longer focal length telescopes to eliminate something known as differential flexure. To read all about this, please visit the link in the description below. It basically talks about the ratio between the focal lengths of your guide scope and your imaging scope and how it can cause problems. Something else about off-axis guiders is that if you have your imaging train spaced properly, you can take it off one scope and put it directly onto another scope. Again, back focus requirements must be equal between two telescopes. The standard is about 55 millimeters. And OAGs aren't only to be used with long focal length telescopes, they also work really well with refractors and short focal length Newtonians. Sitting in our number 3 spot for recommended equipment upgrades into the advanced astrophotography position is an upgraded equatorial mount with a weight capacity of 45 pounds or more. As you start to progress into this advanced category of astrophotography, you're inevitably going to own more than one scope, and larger telescopes require better tracking accuracy. Imaging with a 10-inch Newtonian or a 10-inch RC definitely requires that extra payload capacity, otherwise you're not going to get consistent guiding results. Sitting in our number 2 spot is a larger aperture telescope with a longer focal length. A larger aperture or lens or mirror is going to result in higher resolution and more light gathering power. Of course, you need a larger equatorial mount for this, but if you really want to get up close and personal on nebular detail and galaxies, more aperture is going to be key. By increasing your aperture, you're increasing your signal to noise ratio, your light gathering power, and to be honest, the difference between a single subexposure through a 10-inch Newtonian and a 3.5-inch refractor is absolutely staggering. And our number 1 top recommended upgrade into the advanced astrophotography category is, of course, a dedicated monochrome camera. The huge advantage of a monochrome camera is their ability to capture more light and have a higher resolution, given the fact that they are monochrome sensors and do not have an integrated Bayer matrix. A one-shot color camera does have an integrated Bayer matrix, which means each individual pixel is layered with a red, green, or blue filter, and this is the number 1 reason why we recommend a monochrome camera over a one-shot color for advanced astrophotography. Monochrome cameras are also highly versatile when it comes to narrowband imaging and post-processing as well. So if this list wasn't enough for you and you're too advanced for even these recommended items, then take a listen to these next items that we're going to recommend for expert astrophotographers, starting off with a pier or an observatory. Imagine being able to walk outside, pull off your telegizmo, off of your pier, hit run sequence, and you are up and imaging for the night. With a pier or an observatory, you no longer have to go out and set up and tear down every single night of imaging. This just all in all saves so much time. All right, so our second recommended upgrade for expert astrophotographers are, of course, 3-nanometer filters. A tighter bandpass is going to allow for better transmission of light in the wavelengths that we utilize, which is hydrogen alpha, oxygen 3, and sulfur 2. A tighter bandpass is going to increase contrast, it's going to reduce light pollution gradients, it's going to reduce the size of your stars, all while maximizing detail. Pricey, yes, but if you are in this for the long haul, absolutely worth it. Our last recommended upgrade for expert astrophotographers are larger optics, but also faster optics. A fast telescope, which refers to a telescope with a focal ratio of f2, f3, or f4, is going to increase your light gathering capabilities over a telescope of the same size with a focal ratio of f8 or f10. So if you choose to purchase a fast focal ratio telescope, something like a Celestron RASA, a Hyperstar attachment to your SCT, or even an F4 Newtonian, you may want to consider high-speed filters, specifically narrowband filters. Telescopes with a focal ratio of F4 are fine to be used with 3 and 5 nanometer filters, but if you really want to use faster optics like F2 or F3, you're going to need to consider high-speed filters. The Beta F2 high-speed filter sets are fantastic for Celestron RASAs and Hyperstar attachments. Okay, so that is it for our video over recommended upgrades for advanced and expert astrophotographers. If you're interested, take a look into our first two videos in the series, and we talk about recommended upgrades for beginner and intermediate astrophotographers. That being said, if you like this video, please be sure to like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any of our future content. As always, we love hearing from our customers and from our viewers, so in the comments below, let us know what your biggest equipment upgrade was into advanced or expert astrophotography. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below or reach out to us at highpointscientific.com, and our non-commissioned product advisors will be more than happy to assist. Thank you so much, and clear skies.